Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Saurabh Mani Tripathi and you are watching my YouTube channel, EE Lectures. Through this video, I am going to clarify the answers to a few multiple choice questions related to the DC machines. So let us look at the first question. The EMF induced in a coil rotating in a magnetic field is the maximum when the options are the rate of change of flux linkage by the coil is the minimum. The rate of change of cutting of flux by the coil sides is the minimum. The flux linkage by the coil is the maximum. The rate of change of flux linkage by the coil is the maximum. Before I explain the answer to a question, I suggest you to get the video paused and find the answers by yourself. Once you find the answer by yourself, replay the video and match your answer with the correct one, which I will let you know with an explanation. As we know, the generator action is based on the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, which requires a relative motion between the conductor and the magnetic field. As can be seen in this figure, at vertical position of the coil plane, the flux linkages to the coil plane is the maximum. When the coil is about to turn, the coil sides would slide parallel to the magnetic flux lines, and therefore the coil sides do not cut the magnetic flux lines. So in this position, no EMF is induced in the coil. On the other hand, at the horizontal position of the coil plane, the flux linkages to the coil plane is the minimum. However, there occurs maximum rate of change of flux, and therefore the induced EMF in the coil is also the maximum. So the last option is the correct one. Next question is, the distance between the second conductor of one coil and the first conductor of the next coil being connected to the common commutator segment is called. The options are pole pitch, back pitch, front pitch, resultant pitch. As can be seen in this figure, this is the second conductor of one coil and this is the first conductor of the next coil. And these are connected to common commutator segment. Clearly, the distance between the second conductor of one coil and the first conductor of the next coil is nothing but the front pitch. So, the third option is the correct one. Next question is, the induced EMF in a DC machine is 200 volt at a speed of 1000 RPM. What will be the electromagnetic torque developed at an armature current of 10 ampere? The options are 19.1 Newton meter, 52.3 Newton meter, 2.1 Newton meter, 2 Newton meter. Now recall, the torque equation of the DC motor is given by this equation. Here we have EB is equal to 200 volt, IA is equal to 10 ampere, and N is equal to 1000 RPM. Substituting all these values in the torque equation, we have developed electromagnetic torque as 19.1 Newton meter. So the first option is the correct one. Next question is, the armature of a 6-pole DC machine is rotating at a speed of 10 revolutions per second. The number of hysteresis loops formed per second will be. The options are 30, 10, 60, 6. As we know, when any particular segment of the armature core passes under successive north and south poles due to the rotation of the armature, the magnetic domains in that particular segment of the armature core material are subjected to the magnetic field reversals. When the armature core passes through a pair of poles, one hysteresis loop is formed. Here, the number of poles is 6. So, the number of pole pairs will be 3. Hence, the number of hysteresis loops formed per second will be 3 multiplied by 10, that is equal to 30. This way, the first option is the correct one. Next question is, if an external resistance is added to the field of a DC shunt generator, it results in. The options are increase in the speed of the generator, increase in the voltage of the generator, decrease in the voltage of the generator, increase in the power delivered. When you add an external resistance to the field winding of a DC shunt generator, the field current will decrease, which in turn will cause the reduction in the field flux. Now recall the EMF equation of the DC generator, from which we can easily conclude that the reduction in the field flux will result in decrease in the generated voltage. Hence, the third option is the correct answer. Next question is, a 6-pole DC generator is running at 1500 RPM. The frequency of current in the armature winding of the DC generator will be, the options are 50 Hz, 60 Hz, 75 Hz, 100 Hz. As we know, the current generated in the armature winding of the DC generator remains of alternating nature, the frequency of which can be determined using the equation N is equal to 120 F by P. Here, N is equal to 1500 RPM, P is equal to 6. So, the frequency will be 1500 multiplied by 6 and divided by 120. This gives F is equal to 75 Hz. So, the third option is the correct one. Next question is, hysteresis loss in a DC machine is reduced by 1 and eddy current loss by 2. The options are a special steel, less current, less flux, less current, more poles, thin insulated laminations, a special steel, thin insulated laminations. As a matter of fact, the hysteresis loss depends upon the maximum flux density in the magnetic material and the frequency of magnetic reversal. On the other hand, the eddy current loss depends upon the square of the lamination thickness. In view of these facts, the hysteresis and eddy current losses in the DC machine can be reduced by choosing a special steel for the armature core and keeping the lamination thickness as small as possible. Hence, the last option is the correct answer. Next question is, the greater percentage of heat loss in a DC machine is due to. The options are hysteresis loss, eddy current loss, copper loss, frictional loss. As we know, the copper loss is proportional to the square of the current. In reality, the armature current of the DC machine is very large, and therefore, a greater percentage of heat loss in a DC machine is due to the armature copper loss. Hence, the third option is the correct one. Next question is, rotational losses consist of, the options are magnetic and mechanical losses, magnetic and copper losses, magnetic and stray losses, mechanical and copper losses. Actually, in the analysis of DC machines, it is a common practice to lump the mechanical losses and the magnetic loss together. The sum of these two losses is called the rotational losses. Hence, the first option is the correct answer. Now, the last question is, a series motor has a resistance of 2 ohm between its terminals. The motor runs at 1000 RPM at 220 volt, taking a current of 10 ampere. What will be the speed at which the motor will run when connected in series with a 8 ohm resistance and taking the same current at the same supply voltage? The options are 666.7 RPM, 600 RPM, 333.3 RPM, 750 RPM. Since the resistance between the terminals of DC series motor is 2 ohm, therefore we have RA plus RSE is equal to 2 ohm. VT is equal to 220 volt. The current in the armature and series field windings is equal to 10 ampere. External resistance to be added in second condition is equal to 8 ohm. And the speed of the motor in the first operating condition is equal to 1000 RPM. Now recall the back EMF equation of the DC motor. Since the series field current is intact in both the operating conditions, therefore the field flux remains constant throughout. This way, we have the back EMF proportional to the speed only. Hence, we may write EB2 over EB1 is equal to N2 over N1, where the subscripts 1 and 2 represent the first and second operating conditions respectively. Therefore, N2 is equal to N1 multiplied by EB2 over EB1. Using the current voltage relationship for the DC series motor, we may calculate EB1 is equal to 200 volt and EB2 is equal to 120 volt. Substituting all these values, we have the motor speed in second operating condition as 600 RPM. Hence, the second option is the correct one. That's it for now. Keep watching and do like this video and subscribe to my channel. Please don't forget to share your learning experiences on this short video. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.